All right, guys, it's Saturday. It's the weekend. Amazing! What's going on, YouTube? This is your boy, Sam, from Teen Sam Rex on here. Happy Saturday! Hopefully, you guys are enjoying your weekend. Good morning. Make sure you guys grab a cup of coffee, because every single day this week, I've been uploading, like, nonstop. Come on! In today's video, I'm coming at you with a brand new Tri-Brigade deck profile for the 2020 format. Guys, Tri-Brigades, in my opinion, not really a art. It's not really a deck you can make with Tri-Brigades, but, like, you can't really play pure Tri-Brigades. You need to splash the deck with other things. It's an engine deck that splashes really well with a bunch of other decks. So, Tri-Brigades, I truly believe this is the best way to play the deck. And I'll showcase you some cool combos you guys can do with this deck. So make sure you guys stay tuned for that. As always, for those of you here on the channel for the very first time, consider on hitting the subscribe button and make sure you guys turn on this. Whoa! Where did that thing go? I don't know. Anyways, don't forget to break or cut elbow that thumbs up button for more awesome Yu-Gi-Oh videos, man. All right, guys, don't waste any more of your time. Without further ado, let's get started with a brand new competitive Tri-Brigade deck profile for the 2020 format. All right, guys, let's begin. All right, guys, welcome to the brand new Tri-Brigade deck profile for the 2020 format post-Phantom Rage. So without further ado, let's just dive straight into the deck profile. So first and foremost, for the Tri-Brigade monsters, the most important monster in the entire deck is Triple Tri-Brigade Fractal. This card is absolutely incredible. For those who do not know what these cards do, Fractal has amazing ability where it reads that you can send this card from your hand or field to the graveyard, send one level 3 or large beast warrior or winged beast monster from your deck to the grave. So this card sends this card from your hand or field to the graveyard, Forge Burials, a level 3 or lower beast monster, directly from your deck to the graveyard. This card is absolutely phenomenal to start off all your combo plays when it comes to utilizing your Tri-Brigade Link monster. And all the Tri-Brigade monsters has this ability where it reads that you can banish any number of beasts, beast warrior, and or winged beast monsters in your graveyard, special summon one beast, beast warrior, or winged beast monster from your extra deck with link rating equal to the number of banish. Also, you can only use beast, beast warrior, and winged beast monsters as link material for the rest of this turn. You can only use each effect of Tri-Brigade Fractal once per turn. So all the Tri-Brigade monsters has the ability to banish X amount of beast, winged beast, beast warrior monsters from a grave to link summon a beast, beast warrior, or winged beast monster from your extra deck. So Fractal, really amazing to Foolish Burial your Tri-Brigade monsters to the graveyard. Next off, to pair off with Tri-Brigade Fractal, you're gonna play two copies of Tri-Brigade Nerval right here. This card is absolutely incredible. Same effect as Fractal, banish X amount of beast, beast warrior, or winged beast monster to link summon a beast, beast warrior, or winged beast monster from your extra deck. But this card has an amazing secondary ability where it reads that if this card is sent to the graveyard, you can add one Tri-Brigade monster from your deck to your hand. So this card is your roto for the deck. So what you would do with Nerval is that you would send this card to the graveyard using Fractal's ability, and then you can activate Nerval's effect to basically search any copy of your Tri-Brigade monsters directly from your deck to your hand. Which is absolutely incredible. So Nerval is just really good for that, to get access to all your combo plays as quickly as possible. And this is why Fractal is the most important starter for the entire deck, because this card right here dumps Nerval. Nerval will search Fractal. You can normal summon Fractal. At this point, you have two Beast Warrior and or Winged Beast monster in your graveyard, which is Nerval and also Fractal. Banish the two to special summon a Link monster from the extra deck, which is absolutely incredible. So this card is a one card combo in the deck, which is incredible. So two copies of Nerval and obviously three copies of Fractal right here. And the last Tri-Brigade monster playing in the deck is double copies of Tri-Brigade Karaz right here. This card is absolutely phenomenal. A lot of people play this card at one, but I feel like this card is actually really important with the two engines that I have built into this deck. Remember, guys, Tri-Brigade isn't really a pure variant deck. You need to splash it with a bunch of Winged Beasts or Beast Warrior or beast type deck, right? So the best engine to pair off Tri-Brigades is obviously with Zodiacs, in my opinion, and the deck just flows really well, especially opening up with Karaz and a Zodiac monster. You pretty much have full combo with Appaloosa playing around the bureau, which is insane. So this card is so good. You can discard one other beast, beast warrior, or winged beast monster from your hand, special this card, and then same effect, you can banish X amount of beast, beast warrior from your graveyard to link summon a beast, beast warrior, or winged beast monster in your extra deck. So Karaz, absolutely phenomenal. I think it's one of the best standards in the deck, especially opening up with Karaz and Zodiac Ram Ram guarantees you RAM setup, which is absolutely phenomenal. So Correz, absolutely amazing. Still currently testing his build right now. I was actually struggling between 2 to 3 copies of this card, but I actually cut the third copy to play more impactful cards in today's meta, like hand traps and things like that. And you guys will see in a second, but Correz, actually really nice. You guys can play 1, 2, or 3, but I felt like for this variation of the deck where I focus on actually comboing off, I felt like Correz is just incredible, right? So card is so good. So that will pretty much round off for all your Tri-Brigade monsters. Next off, no need to explain this engine right here. We're playing Zeus. So you're playing, of course, 1 rat, triple thorough blade right here, triple whiptail. And last but not least, I'm playing 3 copies of Zodiac Ram Rim right here. So no need to further explain Zodiacs. This is literally the best Beast Warrior engine to partner off alongside Tri-Brigades. And you guys will see some of the cool combos you guys can actually do with this deck. Like literally Kuraz, or you know, Tanky Ram Ram or Kuraz Ram Ram will give you a really first turn incredible board without having to use a normal summon to make your Appaloosa. So you can actually make Appaloosa and like Dryden Pass by just opening up with like Kuraz and also Ram Ram and another Zodiac monster or basically another normal summon. So this engine is just insane, and that's why Kuraz is so good, because it synergizes really well with all these Zodiac cards. These are all Beast Warrior. You can ditch from your hand to the graveyard, especially on this card, and Kamalov with these, right? So Kuraz is just so good. So essentially like a 1.52 card combo with the deck right here. So we got the Zeus engine. Next off, the only 2 bricks I'm playing the deck is the 1 Buffalo and also the 1 Stormwinds. I feel like these cards are one of the most integral parts of the combo variant of Tri-Brigade Zodiacs. You guys will understand a little bit better why Buffalo is important, but getting access to your Appaloosa without having to use a normal summon is just insane. And obviously, Barrier Statue, the Stormwinds, this card is so good because you can easily summon off some more, and Fractal is a 1-card some more. And it's literally a 1-card Vanny's emptiness, right? Which is insane. So Fractal getting access to this on the field on the very first turn is just insane to lock your opponent from only special summoning wing monsters. And yeah, you guys will see in a second how crazy the combo is when it comes to just using 1 card to help you get a special summoning lock on the field. So these two are kind of like the Garnets in the deck, but they're really important to combo off with this variation of Tri-Brigade Zodiac. So 1 Buffalo and also the 1 Stormwinds. Next off for your hand traps, you're playing, of course, triple Ash Blossom and Joy Spring. I'm also playing triple Infinite Impermanence in the deck as well. And last but not least, for one of the best cards going second, is I'm playing triple Alpha, the Master of Beasts right here. This card is absolutely phenomenal. I love Alpha, especially in any Zodiac variant deck. Card is so good. Works really well with Tri-Brigades because this card's a beast, so you can always discard it a Fractal if needs be. But this card's like one of the best cards going second and actually helping cracking boards. Your entire deck is all Beast Warrior, so functions really well with Alpha, the Master of Beasts. And just these cards can be any 9 cards you guys would like, any 9-versatile hand traps or trap cards, whatever you guys prefer. So these 9 slots can be any 9-card slots you guys would want to play in your deck. I feel like these 9 cards are just perfect towards my playstyle. So that's pretty much a round off for cards going second and also our hand traps right here. Next off for your spells, I'm playing triple Tri-Brigade Airborne Assault. This card is absolutely phenomenal. So this card's a quick play, which is really important for Tri-Brigades. What this card does is that target one Beast Warrior or Winged Beast monster you control, special one Beast Warrior or Winged Beast monster from your deck in defense position with a different type and with attack less than or equal to that monster, but its effects are negated until the end of this turn. Also, you cannot special summon monsters from the extra deck for the rest of this turn except for Link monsters. So the most important part about this card is that one, it gets access to your Beast Warrior and also Winged Beast monster directly from your deck, like cards like Whiptail, which is actually really awesome. So that way you can reattach it to the Dryden during your turn, which is really nice. So Assault is great. And with Shurag right here, this card has an amazing ability where it reads that if this card is special or if another Beast Warrior or Winged Beast monster is special into your field, you can banish 1 card on the field. And this effect doesn't target at all. So having to open it up with, of course, Shurag and also Airborne Assault, you can easily activate Airborne Assault, special the monster, and then Shurag will trigger off its effect to basically banish a card on the field, which is incredible. So Airborne Assault is really nice. One of the best standards in the entire deck. And also one of the cards that just provides you an interruption while Shurag is on the field, right? So this card is just absolutely phenomenal. Next off, since your entire deck are all Beast Warriors, you're playing, of course, Triple Fire Formation Tanky. Card's amazing. Searches basically your entire deck, which is good. And last but not least, I'm playing the 1 Zodiac Barrage. In my yesterday's Zodiac deck profile, for some reason, I cut this card out during the editing process, so I'd like to apologize for that. So if you guys watched my Zodiac deck roll yesterday, you're obviously playing Barrage. This card's the best card in your entire deck, so Barrage is just very, very nice. So triple Tanky, triple Barrage, really good. Next off, of course, Call by the Grave. Card's amazing to ensure that your combos always go through. And last but not least, around our spells, we're playing, of course, Double Pot Avarice. You're playing Zeus. Zeus can easily put 5 monsters in the graveyard in the very first turn. Should reshuffle them back into the deck, draw 2 cards, which is really good. Recycles your Link monsters to the extra deck, draw 2 cards. Absolutely amazing. So Pot Avarice is just very, very nice. And last but not least, for your traps, I'm playing the one Tri-Brigade Revolt. And last but not least, for our traps, I'm playing, of course, the one copy of Tri-Brigade Revolt. I see a lot of decks play two copies of this, but only one Ominous Omen. I felt like if you're playing the combo version of the deck, only one copy is needed. I felt like the extra deck space for this combo variant is so tight that you don't have room to play a lot of Tri-Brigade monsters. This card's basically like Return of the Different Dimensions for Tri-Brigades. Basically, you can special summon any number of your Beast, Beast Warrior, and or Winged Beast monsters that are banished and are in your graveyard, but negate their effects. Then immediately after this card resolves, Link summon one Tri-Brigade Link monster using only those monsters. So basically special summon as many, Link into the Link Force Shurag. You basically have a free Link 4 on the field and an interruption, which is absolutely phenomenal. So Tri-Brigade Revolt is just really, really good to Link summon during your opponent's turn to banish a card, which is important. So the one Revolt, still struggling between one or two copies of this card, but it's all up to personal preference. There are so many different variations of Tri-Brigade Zubiacs out there you guys can never play. You guys can always play decks according to your own playstyle. But for this deck and the combo variation of the deck, I'm only playing one copy of Revolt in this deck. So that'll pretty much round off for the main deck. Let's go off to your extra deck real quick. Alright guys, like I mentioned earlier, the extra deck is super tight. So I'm only playing one copy of Baron Blossom. Only one copy. She's absolutely phenomenal. And also Omen. Like I said, if this card is special summoned, or a Beast Warrior or Winged Beast Monster is special summoned while this card's on the field, you banish one card, which is amazing. Doesn't target, which is really good. If this card is sent to the graveyard, you can add one Beast Warrior or Winged Beast Monster directly from your deck to your hand, whose level is less or equal to the number of your banished Beast Warrior and or Winged Beast Monster. So it's basically search any Zodiac or any of your Tri-Brigade monsters directly from your deck to your hand. But most importantly, this card is an interruption during your opponent's turn, which is insane. Baron Blossom is really good. During your main phase, you can special summon level 4 or lower of Beast Warrior or Winged Beast Monster from your hand. Also, you cannot special summon Link monsters for the rest of this turn except for Beast Warrior and or Winged Beast Monster. If this card is sent to the graveyard, you can draw one card, then place one card from your hand to the bottom of the deck, which is really, really good. So these two cards are amazing. Like I said, this is a combo variant of the deck, so the extra deck stays is just super duper tight. But if I could cut one card in the extra deck, I would just cut it and just play another copy of Ominous Omen, and I'll play two copies of Tri-Brigade Revolt. But with Ivory's, you can easily recycle these cards back and utilize Revolt, so it's not that bad. But if you want to play two copies of this, I'll definitely recommend it. But just because the extra deck is so tight, I don't have space to play a second one. Next off, of course, some more, one of the best combo pieces in the entire deck, brings out the Barrier Statue, one Megaclops, which is really great, one Apollosa, Bull of the Goddess, one Ancient Warrior Oath, double Dragon Lord. This card is so good. It's basically like a Hieratic Seal, which you can easily summon off your Tri-Brigade monsters. It is a Beast Warrior Link 2 monster, which is insane. So any of your Tri-Brigade can summon this. And next you're playing, of course, the one Cloudier Beast Dragasses right here. The only reason why this card is in here is because it's a Winged Beast and it's a win. So you can easily banish two cards in your graveyard off your Tri-Brigade monster, special summon this, and then link it to your Samori, which is really good. And that's why Dragas is in here. And last but not least, you're playing, of course, Brother Fire for his Eagle. Eagle is in here because of the buffalo play to help get you access to Apollosa, which is really good. And Apollosa is really great. Pretty much round off for your links. For your XCs, of course, you're playing, of course, the one Zeus. Really great card going second. Double Shaconine. The one Borbo. Really great card still to make Zeus. Double Tiger Mortar. And last but not least, the one Dryden, of course. To round off for all the Zodiac XCs monsters. You're playing this deck right here. So Zeus works really well with Tri-Brigades, and I'll show you guys some crazy combos you guys can do with this deck right now. These are some of the most important combos that you guys need to know about when it comes to utilizing Tri-Brigades and also Zodiac monsters in this deck right here. If you guys want to see more in-depth combos of Zodiac and the full combo guy, I've been watching this guy named Sorbent for quite some time now, learning a lot about Zodiacs and Tri-Brigades. Make sure you guys check out his channel. I'll leave more combos in the description box below for you guys to check out. Also, before we get started with the deck profile, if you guys haven't gotten your Spirit Charmers playmat, what are you guys doing? Get your playmats today in the link down below at tx1.com. All right, guys, first combo, very simple. All you need is Tri-Brigade Fractal, and this is literally the bread and butter combo of this deck. If you have Fractal in hand, you can activate this card. Send this card to the graveyard to dump Nurgle into your graveyard. Okay, and once Nurgle will get sent to the graveyard, Nurgle will activate its effect to search Fractal directly from your deck to your hand. And now since you have a normal summon yet, you can normal summon Fractal. Okay, activate Fractal's ability to banish these two Beast Warrior monsters in your graveyard, to link summon into your Gladiator Beast Dragasses right here. And now using these two monsters, okay, a Beast Warrior and also a Winged Beast monster, link these two to the graveyard to special summon, of course, your Simorgh, Bird of Sovereignty right here. Alright, and during the end phase, you activate Simorgh's effect to basically special summon Barrier Statue of Stormwinds directly from your deck. So that's a basic bread and butter combo when it comes to utilizing Tri-Brigade monsters. You want to try to get access to this lock as quickly as possible so that your opponent cannot play Yu-Gi-Oh! If your opponent can't break this lock for some reason during the end phase, you can actually activate Sovereignty's effect to special and of course Tri-Brigade Nerval directly from the deck. And the reason why you can special summon Nerval is because this card is a wind. And obviously you're locked to special and wins. The cool bread and butter play of the deck, only one fractal, literally gives you a Vanity's Emptiness, which is why this deck is insane. So that's pretty much it for combo number one. Alright guys, for combo number two, I'm going to showcase you guys a combo where utilizing Tenki and Ramram will get you access to Appaloosa without having to rely on actually using your normal summon. Nibiru does hurt this deck a lot, but the beauty about this deck is that you can actually play through Nibiru like it's nothing. So opening up a Tenki and any Zodiac monster will basically give you this board right here. So yes, so what you're gonna do is you're gonna activate your Tenki. Tenki is gonna send your Tri-Brigade Fractal directly from your deck to your hand. And now what you're gonna do is you're gonna send your Fractal to the graveyard, dump Nerval right here. Nerval will activate its effect to search your Kuraz directly from your deck to your hand. So you have Tenki, Ramram and Kuraz in your hand. So now what's gonna happen next is that you're gonna send your Ramram to the graveyard to special summon Kuraz to your side of the field. Now what you're gonna do is you're gonna activate your Kuraz effect. You're gonna banish your Nerval and also your Fractal right here to link it to your Fire Fist Eagle. And now what you're gonna do is you're gonna activate Eagle's effect. You're gonna bounce Tenki to your hand to send Buffalo to the graveyard. And now you get to trigger off Buffalo's effect to freely special summon itself without having to send any Fire Formation cards to the graveyard because you have Eagle on the field. This is your first, second, third summon, and on your fourth summon, you're gonna link these two to link it to your Appaloosa right here, which is absolutely phenomenal. So this is four summons without having to use a normal summon. So imagine you open up with any other Zodiac monster and actually make Dryden with Appaloosa without having to worry about the Biru, which is absolutely insane. And also the following turn, you have Fire Formation Tenki, which you can freely activate for your follow-up plays, which is absolutely incredible. So that's pretty much combo number two. Let's go up to the last and final combo for the deck. Tenki, Nerval, and Whiptail is optional. Here's how the combo is gonna work. So first and foremost, you're gonna activate Fire Formation Tenki, search a copy of Rapier directly from your deck to your hand. And now what you're gonna do is you're gonna normal summon Rat, activate Rat's effect to send Ramram to the graveyard. And now what you're gonna do is you're gonna overlay for Shaconine. Shaconine activates ability to revive back Ramram from your graveyard. And now what's gonna happen next is that you're gonna go into your Trident. Trident activate effect to detach a material to pop your Ramram. Okay, once Ramram gets destroyed, Ramram will get its effect to special summon back Shaconine to your side of the field. Remember, this card is not a heart once per turn, so since you brought this card back, you can utilize the effect once again. And done on top of Dryden, you can make your Tiger Mortar, and then you can activate your Tiger Mortar's effect to detach a material to equip back to Shaconine. And now since Shaconine has material, you can activate Shaconine's effect to detach a material to special summon back Dryden to your side of the field. Using Shaconine and also Tiger Mortar, you're gonna link these two cards to the graveyard to link summon into your Barren Blossom. Especially your Barren Blossom right here. Now since Barren Blossom is summoned, you can get to activate Barren Blossom's effect to special summon your Tri-Brigade Nerval from your hand. So, and now what's gonna happen next is that since you have exactly four Beast Warrior monsters in the graveyard, you're gonna banish 1, 2, 3, 4. Banish these four cards using your Nerval's effect to basically special summon your Shurag. And now using Nerval and also Barren Blossom right here to link summon into your Simorgh right here. And now during the end phase, you get to activate Simorgh's effect to special summon your Barrier Statue directly from the deck, which is insane. So this is off two cards, by the way, and Whiptail is in here, so you can activate Whiptail to equip it to Dryden, so you have an additional pop during your opponent's turn, which is amazing. If this board were to survive, you can actually activate your Simorgh's effect during the end phase to special another copy of Nerval directly from the deck, and once Nerval is summoned, Shurag will also get a trigger off its effect to banish a card on the field. Dryden is insane. The whole deck is just really, really crazy. So I believe this deck is actually very awesome. If you guys want to see more in-depth combos, check out in the link in the description box below. So let me know your thoughts about this deck. I feel like it's one of the top-tier decks this format. And combining Zodiacs and also Tri-Brigades literally makes one amazing deck. Try this deck out for yourself. Let me know what your thoughts about this deck in the comments below. And this is your boy Sam from Team Zodiac Sam signing out. All right, guys. Peace.
Be sure to get your playmat today at tsx1.com.